Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at the menu bar. So the menu bar is what's here at the very top of your screen. It's always at the top of the screen, never a part of the window. New Mac users sometimes get a little confused because they're used to other operating systems where the menus are attached to different windows. So somebody says, say, go to File, Save, and you look here inside the application for a File button or something. But usually when somebody says Choose or do a command, they mean to go all the way to the top of the screen and look here at the menu bar. Now the menu bar always has an Apple menu here at the top left. It has a little apple as a symbol and we call it the Apple menu. And the interesting thing about the Apple menu is it's the same no matter what application you're running, whereas everything else in the menu bar will change depending upon what application you're running. So here we see things like About This Mac, we see Sleep, Logout, all general things that apply to the computer and to the operating system itself, never to the actual application. The second menu is always named after the application you're currently using. So in this case I'm using Safari, so I have Safari here, and this is one way to figure out what application is currently at the front, the one I'm currently using. And then the menu items here are very similar from app to app. For instance, the Quit menu choice is always here, and there's usually an About and things like that. You also find like Hide here and Preferences usually. But this menu will change depending upon which app you're using. So say if we switched applications here, we would see that this menu would change. Let's go and switch to Maps. And we see now it changes to say Maps instead of Safari. And some of the menu items change, but some are the same. There's a Quit, there's Hide and Show. But you notice there's no preferences here in Maps, so that's not listed here. Also notice many of these other menu choices are about the same. There's some standard menus like File, Edit, View, Window, and Help that even if I were to switch back to Safari, I would see those same menus. There's some new ones. For instance, bookmarks make sense for Safari. So you can see some similarities and some differences. When developers make apps, usually there's certain standards that developers like to follow, and one of those is to include things like the edit menu, even if the edit menu isn't used very much in a certain app. And you'll find similar items there like copy and paste are always under edit, and it doesn't matter which application you're in. You're always going to find copy and paste there. The same for a lot of these other menu items. Now let's look at some more advanced tricks. One of the things that I do all the time but a lot of new Mac users don't know about is that you don't have to search for a menu item. Like for instance, say if I were to remember that there's an option somewhere to show the downloads here in Safari and I don't remember which menu it's under. I could start looking and say it's under Files, under Edit, and eventually find it by looking in View. But I don't need to search for it because sometimes it's very difficult to find these. Sometimes they're very deep down in submenus and it's easier simply to go to the Help here and there's a little search field right inside the menu there and start typing. And when you do that you'll see a list of menu items at the top. Simply roll over it and not only will it allow you to choose it from here, but it will show you that, for instance, this one is in the View menu and that's exactly where it is. And I can just choose it from here if I wanted to. So it's very easy to find a menu item. You don't need to hunt for it. Now another advanced trick is to use the Option key to find hidden menu commands. Let me give you an example here. If I go to File here, I can see that there's a closed tab feature here. And I'll actually open a second tab here so you can see close tab. Now if I were to hold down the Option key I would see that close tab changes to close other tabs. So there's a second command there hidden and I only see it if I use the Option key. And there are a lot of different hidden commands just about in every app. Like for instance, see where it says quit Safari? If I hold the Option key down it'll quit and close all the windows of Safari. So there's a lot of different things that you can do here by holding the Option key down and changing the menu items. Some of the best, coolest features of complex apps are hidden in these Option menu commands. So another cool thing that you can do is you can control menus with the keyboard. So the simplest way to do this is use the mouse first to click on any menu and then I can use the down arrow to go and select. So you see the cursor stays there at the top. I'm using the arrow keys to navigate. I can use the right arrow to go into a submenu. If I'm on an item and doesn't have a submenu, I can use the right and left to go back and forth between these menus. And then I can choose one and use spacebar or return to issue that command. Now let's say you want to do that but you never want to use the mouse at all, so I don't want to have to go up here and click. Well, under System Preferences you can go in System Preferences, Keyboard, and under Shortcuts you can go to the keyboard subsetting here and then look for this one, Move Focus to the Menu Bar. And the default is Control, not Command, but Control F2. And keep in mind also that if you have this thing set or not set, it will change how that works. You may have to use the FN key in addition to Control and F2 depending upon how you have that toggle set. So here I'm going to go in and I'm going to do Control F2, and you can see that the Apple menu there at the top left is selected, and now I can move over and do what I want to issue command from the menu bar without ever touching the mouse or trackpad.